Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and this is the first video in our skeletal muscle tissue series. So we've talked about bone tissue some, we've talked about the basics of joints, and now let's finish off the musculoskeletal system before we get into the actual structures with skeletal muscle tissue. So we're going to start with the discussion of the properties and functions of all muscular tissue. And while the focus of this particular series will be skeletal muscle, as that plays the biggest role in the musculoskeletal system, throughout this course you will be learning about the other main types of muscle, which include cardiac and smooth muscle. But since I have the honor of being the first lecturer in this course, I get to introduce some of the overarching concepts for all muscles. So that's what I'll be describing here, properties and functions of all types of muscular tissue. Muscle will have four properties that allow it to fulfill the functions we will discuss later in this video. And this first one is pretty darn cool, if you ask me. And that is electrical excitability. And yes, I said electrical. This is the ability to respond, so the muscle's ability to respond to certain stimuli by producing electrical signals. All right. And in the case of muscle, these are called muscle action potentials. Often you will see action potentials abbreviated with AP. Electrical excitability is actually a property that muscle shares with nerve cells. So there is a property shared with the nervous system here, which I think is pretty super cool. And you'll be talking about that in a lot more detail in the neurology or neuroanatomy portion of the course. These action potentials will actually travel along the muscle cell's plasma membrane, which you can see here, and we'll talk a bit more about that in subsequent videos. And this is possible due to these ion channels in these regions. Now, there are two means of stimuli that can trigger action potentials in muscle cells. You'll have electrical, which are particularly important in cardiac, autorhythmic muscle, and chemical, which are most commonly neurotransmitters released by neurons. And this is particularly important in skeletal muscle tissue. So you will have acetylcholine that will be released, and that will lead to the action potential. And we'll talk a bit more. We won't get into the full physiology here because this isn't a physiology course, but we'll get a little into some of the specifics here. The last three properties intuitively go together. So you'll have contractility, which is exactly what it sounds like. It's a muscle's ability to contract when stimulated by those action potentials. And with contraction of a muscle, this generates tension while pulling on attachment points. And we will talk about the different types of contraction, which you can see here in this image, in another video, but there will actually be some contractions that will produce tension, but no movement. So there would be no muscle shortening occurring. And then in certain contractions, you'll also actually have the muscle elongating. Extensibility, which is the ability of a muscle to stretch without sustaining damage. And all muscle can stretch to a certain extent, and some muscle types can actually stretch quite a bit more than others. For example, smooth muscle can stretch notably more than cardiac or skeletal muscle in certain areas. And lastly, elasticity is going to be the fourth property, and this is the ability of muscle tissue to return to its original shape and length after extension or contraction. So you really need this last one in order for these to work efficiently. There are four main functions of muscle that are allowable based on those muscle properties that we just discussed. The first is producing body movements, all right? And that one I think we all kind of know. This is all body movements, so not just the obvious ones like walking or running, but it'll play a role in things like talking and even things like urination and many more functions of the body that involve movement of some form. A second function is stabilizing body position, and this involves skeletal muscle in particular. We'll talk quite a bit about postural muscles, which contract continuously to allow for standing or sitting upright. So those play a big role in terms of stabilizing body positions. Next, we will have storing and moving substances within the body. And this is an important function of cardiac muscle, which will move blood throughout the body, and smooth muscle, in particular, it will move all types of substances throughout the body, like food or bile, sperm, oocytes, to name a few. Skeletal muscle does play indirect roles in terms of directing flow of lymph, as well as deoxygenated blood through lower limb veins. So skeletal muscle will play a role here, just not as large as the cardiac and smooth. And lastly, and importantly, a last function of muscular tissue will be that contracting muscle will produce heat. And this is a process called thermogenesis. And you have likely experienced this, particularly those of us that live in Michigan in the winter through shivering, which is involuntary contraction of skeletal muscles. Shivering will dramatically increase the rate of heat production. So those are the four main functions of muscle that go along with the four main properties of muscle. So 4 + 4 equals the function and properties of muscle. All right, let's finish this video by reviewing a concept through assessment. So the question I'm going to ask you is, which property of muscular tissue is shared with nerve cells? Is it contractility, B, elasticity, C, electrical excitability, or D, extensibility? Pause the video to think through this and review your notes if needed. And when ready, I want you to shout out your answer. It's fine. You're probably doing this not around other people. And even if you are, it will be fun to yell out, C, electrical excitability. And that is the correct answer. The other answer choices are very much properties of muscle tissue, but they are not properties of nerve cells. So contractility, elasticity, and extensibility are not correct, but C, electrical excitability, is. All right, that should be it for our discussion of the properties and functions of muscle. In the next video, we will discuss some of the specifics of the three types of muscle tissue. Thank you for your time and attention here, and have a great rest of your day.